don't think there is anything more important when living with metastatic breast cancer than to rest and to learn how to pace oneself. And a lot of us, you know, that I meet and talk to, we're type A, we're, you know, whether it's focusing on our family and cooking, making breakfast every morning and going, oh, we want it all, we're doing. So rest was never something that when I got sick felt comfortable. It felt like I was giving in, that I was giving up, and that rest was, and my doctor kept saying, Pam, you have stage 4. Metastatic breast cancer. Rest is a treatment, and you need to start thinking about rest as a treatment, not as something that you're doing because you can't cope or that you're being lazy or that you need to be productive. Rest is as important as the pills that you're taking, and the rest is helping your pills do their work. It took me a long time to understand that, and once I retired, man, do I understand that. And I thought I would be miserable, but it's been great. So the way to rest is to pace, learn how to pace yourself. It's okay. You know, it's okay to sit on the porch. It's okay to work a jigsaw puzzle. It's okay to just, instead of going out to lunch with your friend, to have a Zoom call or just have a phone schmooze, you know, and learning that is so important. And you're sort of, with the CDK inhibitors and with the diarrhea, sometimes you're sort of forced to stay at home. And, you know, in some ways that also taught me that I got to listen to my body, and staying at home and resting can help so many of those, especially the fatigue.
So I was on leave for about 12 weeks and then my retirement paperwork came in. So I retired at 34, and that was really hard for me because before that, like Pam was saying, I've always been like just a go-getter. And COVID, I know it shut the world down and it impacted people in a lot of different ways, but it made me really realize, like, what am I gonna do? I'm so used to like going. And when I wasn't going, I was advocating at rallies or just being involved in different activities that I didn't just have any pauses. So it really just made me stop and take intake of what was really important. And I feel like that really changed my perception. That's also the time that I realized that my fatigue was awful and I started palliative care. Starting palliative care changed my life. Palliative care, a lot of people are scared of because it's in the hospice center most of the time. But I'd like to just say that it's life-changing and that they treat the symptoms and the person. So it's not end-of-life care. It's just to make sure that your life just day-to-day gets better.
Yeah, I can't say enough about how important it is to start with palliative care as soon as you can so that you're getting the help that you need to manage the symptoms.